run flying and just take the lead, I'll follow you.
What's going on, guys? 2-3 Frank the Tank here. I'm on a Hoggett training server, and I'm going to be doing a video on the targeting pod. I'm just going to have fun with it and lay a couple targets, bomb some stuff, and yeah, it's gonna be good. This is just a training server, and I've got a friend behind me following me, so you might hear some comms between us, but I don't think he's taking any bombs. He's just going to follow me around. So we're at Kobaleti Airfield. That's where we're taking off from. Currently taxiing out. I already warmed up the pod, so once we're in the air, I'm just gonna unstow it and we'll be good to go. Make that my primary selected MFD. Anyone taking off or landing? Okay, run them up.
Copy, let's go.
Let's unstall our pod right here. Let's go to master air ground
mode. We're in paddle 7 in a really weird position. It's really tough. Get those, do what you want them to.
So 87 is the code we're going to use. So let's go here. Gotta turn on your laser. That's very important. 1687 is the code we're going to use. Pull out a burner so I don't have that much fuel. Set the fusing. Make sure I set my code over here as well. 1687. Here, set up all our bombs. Fuse, instant, code, 1687. Step, enter. Okay, perfect. We're gonna start with the big boys.
Online.
Get some altitude. I almost forgot to turn on the obongo. I drop my speed a little bit and gain altitude at the same time, and then we're heading to the little X runway over here, the target practice area. That's basically what that is. Right now we're going to be using the GBU-16, which I think is a 2,000 pound bomb, or a 1,000 pound bomb, yeah. GBU-12s are 500 pounds, and the GBU-16 is 1,000 pounds. So, as you can see, it says 82 laser guided, 83 laser guided, because really just a Mark 82 and a Mark 83 for laser guidance, and you know, nothing more. So since we already have our display set, I'm gonna line myself up with that X runway, continue getting some altitude. I'm just gonna slow down. I should see it around there. There it is. Let's go ahead and zoom in, get our first target ready. Gonna push in the same direction again so we can go to point track. Zoom out a little bit more. I have a pretty sensitive stick, so it's kind of annoying. So I'm gonna box the trigger and then leave it on L arm until I get there. Line my cues up. And this isn't like a tutorial or anything. I'm just kind of explaining what I'm doing as I'm doing it. If you want like a full-blown tutorial, there's great a great tutorial about Red Kite, and there's a great tutorial within the Chugs Guide, which I highly recommend. Chugs Guides will get you ready for basically anything combat related, or just with the plane in general. They're really great. So if you haven't checked them out yet, I highly recommend it. Alright, so we got 35 seconds to go until release. Get myself a little better lined up. So we could pick on this little Soviet Jeep. The only thing that's kind of unfortunate is that we can't have it on a cheek pod because, well, in real life, the Navy just didn't run the targeting pod on the cheek pod. The Marines did, but not the Navy. So, I don't know. And I think it's the Spanish Navy. Okay, we're gonna arm the laser now. Just watch that bad boy go in there. Zoom out a little bit. TTI, 15 seconds. Keep flying straight out. It's gonna be a nice big splash, or shack, I should say. Any second now. Boom. Oof. Very nice. It's very satisfying to watch. Okay, so we're gonna extend out a little bit, probably about 3 miles from the target, and then look for our next target and shack them. So yeah, I mean, this jet is so user friendly. I feel like anybody could pick up the Hornet and learn to fly it. Having Tomcat experience flying this thing is like extremely easy. Now, of course, I haven't really learned the air-to-air modes and really how to use the AIM-120s. I still bat for Phoenix is being superior, especially in a cap environment, but you know, not everybody's gonna agree with me on that one. I'm gonna look forward to ED updating the AIM-120's missile physics, but for now it's kind of weak in terms of range. They do track pretty well, but I think the range could be a lot better. Then again, I don't really know how to use the modes for the radar. To be honest, having a Rio makes life so much easier because you don't have to worry about little things like that. You can focus on flying and just doing your job, and then the Rio just relies on you to go home safely. And yeah, that's basically it. So in a second, we're gonna see this again. The balloons, almost, not yet. Slew him to lock on our target. Okay, I'm gonna turn around now. I already have that locked in. With this, you kind of have to make a decision if you want to have more bombs or you want to have more bags. Now, in a situation like this where the range is so close to the airfields, it doesn't really matter. But in a mission situation, especially in a Hornet, I'd suggest grabbing more, definitely having more bags than bombs, or if you know what I mean, like having a decent mixture. I'd say like grab a 16 on your right wing and a bag on your left wing. That way you kind of have that extra fuel that you might need to get to AO. I'm already at like 8,900 pounds. That's already decently low. It's not too bad, but could be better considering in the Tomcat I already have still have like 16,000 pounds of fuel left at this point, if not more. There's my buddy flying right there, just having a good old time. Turn on my autopilot, make life a little easier. After all, this is a very kid friendly plane. Funny to say it like that, but a kid friendly fighter jet. I feel like anybody could fly it. So obviously I box a trigger over here, which means that my gun trigger is going to be used to laze. So the press of the trigger brings it to L arm, which just means it's like in standby mode. So now I'm going to hold down my pickle button until we get to the release. 3, 2, 1, pickle. Oh no. Okay, pickle. And now I That might be a little bit late. I don't know if that's gonna hit, to be honest with you guys. And now when I press the trigger, it changes to LTDR, which is basically just like, okay, we're lasing the target. But I don't know if it's gonna hit, guys. You saw how late I released that. For some reason, I was holding on the pickle button, but maybe it wasn't exactly motivated by what I was doing. I didn't really want to drop. I was being a little bit lazy, but that's okay. Let's see if it's tracking. Oh, did I even drop anything? Yes, I did. That's weird. I think it missed. Yeah, guys, I think that missed. I don't have a good feeling about that. Yeah, that definitely missed. It's okay, no big deal. We still have four more GBU-12s, which obviously pack plenty of a punch anyways, so that's no big deal. And we've got 8,600 pounds of fuel. I'm gonna send my bingo, which I forgot to do. What actually happened, guys, was I started recording this video, and the server said 10 minutes till restart. So I was like, oh man, I'm gonna have to start the plane all over again and take off, but whatever. I used the last 10 minutes and just shacked two targets and then it restarted, which isn't a huge deal, of course. And I have a lot of fun on the TNN server because it's just chill. Like, I come here to test out weapons without the stress of combat or being shot down or anything. It's like a nice sandbox way to test all your weapons. You can spawn ranges and do all sorts of stuff. So I really enjoy here. And I just come here to hang out with my friends, especially some of my friends that aren't so good with combat yet because they haven't learned or they want to take it slowly. That's okay. There's nothing wrong with learning slowly or taking your time to really get everything together. There's no rush with DCS World. You could learn everything in a week if you want to, or you could take 6 months. It's really up to you. And that's why I like the freedom of a flight sim like DCS. You have the option, you know what I mean? So we're gonna get a revenge here and properly shack this little truck. I'm trying to keep my throttles, decently low. About 12 miles to target. Probably turn a little bit more aggressively, right? We're in a fighter jet after all. Or a bombing Hornet. We're totally fine with bleeding speed. Seconds. There he is, poor guy. Fortunately for them, they're just targets and there's no people inside. But if this was an actual combat server, then there's some poor guys that they won't be coming home to their wives and kids. But that's just war, isn't it? Luckily, this isn't for real or anything like that. Okay, 40 seconds to release. Try to keep that nice and lined up. I'll hold my pickle button for a little bit longer. I'll hold it till a 15-second release cue comes up. That way, I can really ensure that it actually gets released this time. I was like a dollar short and a day late with the release of the last bomb. So let me start holding my pickle button and keep those cues lined up. 10 seconds, as you can all see in the hood, but I don't know why I like to count it out loud. Okay, 2, 1, boom, pickle. We're already lasing the target. So all we do is fly out now. Check out the bomb. It's gonna do its thing. Boom, tracking. That's how it looks like when a bomb is tracking, man. And then we're just gonna watch it go in. like I did with the last couple ones. 2, 1, and big boom. Bye bye. Nice shack. Just so satisfying. Just something about targeting pods that is just a lot of fun to be had. Get our next target ready. Now, I will admit that I personally have more fun with the targeting pod in the F-14 just because there's the interaction between you and the Rio. Like, hey, look here, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, okay, line up right. You got to go a couple degrees to the right. And then, you know, you get to look at it, look at the repeater, showing what he's looking through on the lantern pod and get your steering cues. It's just a lot of fun to me. I really enjoy TGPs in F-14. Now, it's a shame that Jester can't do it, but they did say they were working on it, so maybe one day we'll get that ability, which would be nice. That'd be really nice. We're going to be a little bit more aggressive now. We're coming a little closer. We're not going to fly out so far. Seconds. Timer is pretty accurate. Not super accurate. I feel like the F-14 has a better timer, better time to impact timer. But that's a little bit of a heavy F-14 bias from my side, which is to be expected. Boom. Nice shack. On to the next. Right here. Boom. TDC. Target designate. What the fuck? I pickled another one.
So you might have shot a gun from the kids?
Come again?
You might have shot a gun from the kids, or should I stay out?
Nah, go for it.
Welcome.
So yeah, that was weird. I don't know why it... As soon as I selected a target, I pickled a bomb, but... Oh, that's what happened. I pressed my pickle button instead of my, duh. Alright, we're gonna drop the last bomb here. From quite a low altitude and fast speed. Laser is on. Kind of got everything lined up right at the end, so hopefully it should be a shack.
I'll arm myself with the one going to bearing 25.
Shack. Okay, we're dry. Or we're Judy? Or Winchester? I forget the term. Come again? What happened?
I was just going to shoot the guys on runway 25. Enemies, of course.
Oops, forgot that stuff. No big deal though. 74 X-ray. ILS channel 17. Gotta put away a target plot. Gonna start dumping fuel over here. It's a little confusing, I will admit. Going from a Tomcat to Hornet, but it'd be like that. So there's the Stennis, that's where we're gonna go to.
Altitude.
Of course, it's 321.
Altitude.
deleted my speed and dumped my fuel. We're gonna land on this bad boy over here. Now, obviously, I suck at carry landings in the F-18, just because I'm so used to the Tomcat. But I'm gonna try my hardest to land it properly, or try to. Also, I don't really know the case one alts and positions pertaining to the F-18 specifically. I'm kind of just used to the F-14 and where to brake, where to drop my gear, and all that. So I have to do a little bit more research on the landing procedure on the Hornet for case ones. No big deal. Keep dumping fuel. Could drop my hood. Now obviously I'm not doing a proper Marshall stack, but I don't feel like that's a big deal. I do enough of the serious mission stuff already on my Saturday ops in the Tomcat, so I'm not gonna be too anal about doing everything by the books right now. This server is just where I have fun, kind of like let loose and relax in a way. Experiment, try new weapons, obviously learn new things, especially the Hornet. That's pretty new to me, so should I fill up is still good. See what my buddy's doing. He's coming to land. Oh boy. Ooh, that's gonna be tough. Oh. Come on, man, slow down. Okay, back in my own cockpit. Oh man, very close. Flying dangerously. Keep up the fuel. Get our landing checklist and look at our landing weight. I want to be under 33,000. Spencer's ready off anyways. Harness. God, that landing was terrible. Spectated. Butterized. About to land in status. La la la. Why am I typing? I could literally. I just realized I was typing. I could literally just use the radio. Oh, he occupied a new plane. Maybe he didn't hear that exactly. Alright, that landing weight is basically where I want it, so I'm going to disengage autopilot. The fuel dump should stop itself.
Bingo. Bingo.
Yeah. I'm sorry guys, she might be yelling a bunch when I'm landing, so I guess try the best to ignore it just like I do. I kind of ignore what she says, if you know what I mean. Because if you know anything about Betty, she's bitching constantly. Look, there she goes again. I'm surprised she didn't say anything. She's just beeping at me. I know, buddy. Here. I'm gonna lower my bingo just so you could shut up. I'm gonna lower it to 1500. Which, if I don't get on the carrier deck by then, I guess I'll be in trouble. Jesus Christ. Here we go again. Go to my bit page and stop that. Master reset. I can focus on getting lined up properly. Oh my god. Too much technology, man. It just doesn't shut up. Gonna get up a little bit higher. I'll get to 800 feet. This isn't a tutorial either, because I'm pretty sure for the case one for the Hornet, I'm doing it all wrong. But we'll see. It's just so much different than the Tomcat, I guess. It's like weird to explain. If you fly both, you'll understand the struggle. Deck is clear, as to be expected, because nobody. Jesus, taking forever to slow down. Pretty far out from the stennis, so I'm gonna do a lazy turn in. A beam. Try to keep my altitude up. Rising a little too much. This thing just floats, bro. Holy shit. I gotta get good.
Fuel low.
No, it's not that low. Don't worry about it. A little bit better. A little close this time. That's okay. We'll make it work. Also, another thing is the carrier is moving so slow on this server. That's my like biggest complaint. Is that it goes like 10 miles per hour. I'm used to a carrier going like 29 to 30, so it's a little bit tough to get your timing right when you're, you know, a beam and all that. It's no big deal. Just gotta deal with it, of course. Just love to float. I don't have enough power. Just really temperamental. There it is. Kind of a rough line, but that's okay. Two wire or one wire? It didn't work. Oof, one wire. Alright guys, if you stuck out this far, thank you for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe and support. Almost at 200 subscribers, I'm pretty excited about that. I'm gonna probably do a 200 subscriber cinematic special kind of deal. So I look forward to making that and showing it to you guys. Anyways, take care, have a good day, and see you in the next one.